How's it going, everybody? This is Kinema, and we are back with some more Mineshaft SMP, as you can see. So you may notice something different. What do you notice? What's not here? Did you notice it? No? Yes? My storage. I moved it all, got it all cleaned up, except for that in this, of course. And let's go down here. You may notice quite a bit different. I got a lot of stone brick in here. A lot of stone brick. And I think I actually have a pretty good idea of what I want to do. So if you followed along with the series, I've changed my mind a little bit about what I want to do. But I think I have a pretty solid idea now. And this is the input. I will adjust this. I may make a little kind of like input shack or something up here. So this is what's going to happen. Basically, before I go into it, let's take a look down here. And this is it. So it's kind of a low roof. I was thinking about doing something a little bit larger, putting the redstone up there for the sorting, caused a little bit of issues. So as you can see, I actually have a lot more storage than I need, especially for cobble. That will be fixed. Now, I did not have enough iron to do everything. So you see the stuff over here. I don't have a problem with putting stuff in the chest and sorting it out. I don't know. Sometimes it's one of those things that if I'm on camera and I need to clear my inventory quick, what I have an issue is like putting, you know, mass stuff and everything. So what I did, if we come up here, and hi, by the way, jump right into the action. If we come up here and look at the sorting system, the input chest comes down. I did mess up on this. So basically what happened is there was no little overflow system. So it kind of backed up in there and wrecked that one, powered the one next to it, and then wreck those as well. So I took that out, I reduced it to only one sorter for my stone. You can see that's filled up. Okay, so my stone right now is basically full. Now, I'll show you what's surprising in a minute. Cobblestone, as we saw down there, I have some room for it. This is the cobblestone sorter. I am sorting out dirt and grass blocks. Not that I really need to sort out grass blocks, but it's something else to sort out. So for right now, I'm gonna keep it. The dirt, I don't think I was filling all of them up. So I got tons of storage for dirt and stuff, and there will be plenty more cobble as we come. And then these three sort out diorite, andesite, and granite. I always forget granite. And it sorts it out there, but as you can see, it actually filters it all into one chest, but that goes down into two, filters into two rows. And then of course everything else goes through and drops down into three double chests down there that I can then sort everything out from. So if I'm coming back from a mining trip, drop everything in, the higher items it will filter out. And there's plenty of room for expansion too if I need to. So if we come down here, this is the underneath, the underbelly of the storage room. I left this open. I can probably do some stuff with it. This is half slab, so should not get any spawns down here. Plus, we have the light from the floor above. And we have extra storage for cobble, but then this is off smooth stone. We got two chests there. And I did this that way to convert or merge those down into this, but then I have four chests filled up here. So it's kind of my overflow. I am going to be using a lot of stone brick, and I'll get into that in a second. Not a lot of talking, just a lot of talking. Let's go down. I want to show y'all something at the moment. And so for the fellow mine shafters, if you want a slime farm, I don't know if anyone has their own. If not, they are more than welcome to mine out under my mountain. and build one. It's on my property. So, there, if they want to, if you come down here, I've been doing a little off-camera work. And I was looking for iron. Someone's already been down here. What's with the wooden block? What's with the zombie? So I have thoughts about doing a lot of this. But, and this wooden block. You know, people need to stay out of my stuff. As you can see, okay, we already got one. Slime ball, or slime right here. Hey, little guy. What's up? You know what? I'm going to use... block. So this one, the ones with the high posts, this one right here, and this one right here. If we sit back up and die. Ooh, iron. I'll take that. If we light that up. This has been a little bit annoying with lava. if we kind of get out of the area a little bit. And down here, we are all in the range of the beacon still. Getting to the lower level is kind of where it stops. I could have probably lowered it up top there. But as you can see, nothing spawns. Nothing at all. But, yeah. So, those two right beside each other. I do see slimes spawn in there. Every now and then, there are maybe more mobs down here than... will allow, because there's a lot of strip mines. Spawn is just filled up with strip mines. Some are mine, some are other people's. But I've went up to level 16 and I've been trying to mine out as much as possible. As you can see, of course it's easy to mine out when you have a efficiency 5 pick and haste to beacon. Ooh, I'll take that. Gold. So as you can see, it's very fast. So it really did not take me that long to do this at all. The hardest part was actually, I think the only thing that kind of slows me out, and I would do this a lot more, is the lava pockets. As you can see, all this cobblestone down here. I had to fill up quite a lot of lava areas, which sucks. It kind of slows you down, but that's what you get when you get lava pools. But the reason why, I guess I should go into it, I don't have the seed, and I don't know if Katz has released it to anybody. So if the seed is out there, then... Sorry, my phone just went off. If the seed is out there, I don't know, but I'm not able to check it. So this is what I do on servers that I'm not sure the seed and I want to try to find a slime farm, is you can go down, do this in a few areas, and usually within doing something like this, maybe a, you know, an 8-pin section, and this is right on the borders of the chunk. So I think I actually have 3 blocks. And then a 10 by 10, and then 3 more blocks, which makes up the 16 by 16 chunk. I do that to try to get those slimes. But we already got a ball, 2 balls from that one slime that was there. So nothing else, I guess, is going to spawn. But that's okay. It proved my point. We had a slime in there. And, you know, I've actually gotten several slime balls while digging this stuff out. Which kind of flagged me, and I think you can't see it up here. I had a lapis block over that section close to where the obsidian is in the lava. That spot also has, I've been seeing slime spawn over there as well. And yeah, so that's what's going on down here. So the next thing is, I guess, talk about my base a little bit. And what I plan on doing here. So I do want to get this entrance way. I think that's kind of my next step. But let me go into a little bit of detail up here for a second. Explain a few things. So what I decided to do, and let me go all the way up. Here's good. What I decided to do is I'm actually going to make this kind of like a grass field, like my own little inner mountain oasis. I'm going to level some of the land out with this area. This water is going to kind of create a path and a stream and kind of go down. And it's going to drop off in some areas from up here. The thought process is I'm going to slope all of this down with a lot of dirt and grass blocks. Kind of clean it up. That way I don't have to sit there and decorate the walls. I'll just landscape this like I did the outside. Make it look nice. Put some pockets of sugar cane. Put some random stuff. Maybe put some wheat and some carrots and some trees. And this is just going to slope down there through the layers. And coming out of this, I'm going to do the front of my shop area or my storage room. I'm going to try to do the front something like what I did here and just do like a kind of a nice entrance design. Now it's not going to be like a grand entrance like this, but there is going to be a nice design here because this is going to lead out to grass and that's going to kind of have a path that comes out through this way. Now there will be a door going into here which will lead into my little market area. This is going to have a couple of farms in this particular area. It's going to have my enchanting station and other things like that. And the layout of things, I know what I want in here. The layout may change a little bit depending on what happens, you know, depending on how I get it all set up. So this bottom part, and this should actually go pretty quick because what I'm gonna do first is kind of what I started. Can you see it? You can see it up there. I'm gonna line this whole area. As you can see, I'm gonna line this entire inside void area with stone bricks. That way I know that's my boundary. And I don't have to do that. It is extra work, but I figured I'm gonna do that. I've already got the areas kind of cleared, so I can kind of come back and work on I can kind of come back and it fill in stuff underneath it if I wanted to, but this way when you look, you're going to be able to come out of my shop, you're going to be able to come out of my storage room, look at this nice open grass field, this nice ceiling decorated, there'll be some trees, some paths. I would like to do kind of a rock or stone cave using the same concept that I did out here, kind of make it look very similar to this side where I have the stone, the gravel, the cobble, the vines, the little random leaf blocks and stuff like that. And all of it's going to be lit up and spawn proof. I'm going to do the same walkthrough stuff that I did on the outside of the mountain in here. And then there's going to be at one point a cave coming up. And I haven't decided exactly where I want it. I need to get the bottom tunnel built first. So this tunnel area, there's going to be a kind of like a tunnel with this same type of pathway cutting through it. And if we come up here, what I would like to do is do something like this. Different designs have pillars going ahead and going up like this. I haven't decided if I'm going to do something with all stone. I would really like the all stone look, I think. I really like what I did in this corner. Get a feel for it. I think it also get a feel for it like going up here, kind of. You know, I don't know. I think it's unique, but kind of do like this feel on the lining that those tunnels. Now, the one concern, and I see it kind of happening, and that's also going to look like the walls or the floor, and also possibly the ceiling. Now, the ceiling of the tunnel, I want to keep with my same ceiling theme. So I know I'm running all over the place here. The ceiling with the tunnel, I want to kind of keep with that. So there's going to be some random blocks and stuff kind of cutting through it. Yes, it's not based off of Danny's tunnel, but I'm going to have that. But that tunnel is going to cut underneath my farm. Now it's a farm. It's a shop, a farm, whatever. And there's underneath that first building that I built, the storage room. It's going to cut underneath there, and I can still go down. I'm going to have to mine some of this out already. I see that. I started to down here. You can see I did that a little bit. So this is going to take some work to mine it out and get it correctly done. But I think once I get that done, then I'll kind of half slab that portion and remove all these platforms after I get the layout I want completed of the kind of the sloped floor area. So all in all, I think it will look pretty cool. If another rambly talky episode, all in all, I think it will look pretty cool. The landscape will slowly kind of slope down and meet up with that. I don't know if I'm going to kind of do like a bowl area, but I do want that water stream kind of cutting through and, you know, running down to like a lake area as well. And I don't know, I have a lot of different plans, and I think that's the direction I want to go. I've changed my mind several times, but I really like that direction. So let me know what you think. At this point, what I'm going to do is kind of show y'all what I was working on for this. Basically just placing. Let's go down one. Drop three. Now, it doesn't mean this is going to be where the ground level is. This is just going to be where the stone is, and then I may put one or two layers of dirt on top of it. What did I do? Three? Yeah. And it will just kind of come out. And why I'm putting the stone blocks underneath it, it's just because. I mean, if I'm putting water and stuff, that way I don't get the seep through effect. I could just do half slabs, just turn them upside down or something. That way I put blocks and things on top of them. But I'm just doing this to kind of mark out. And then plus, if I want to do something under here, I already have a ceiling. I just then need to kind of go back and manipulate it some, or clean it up, or do something fun with it. And I don't know. It, to me, I like the idea. You'll have to let me know in the comments what you think as far as, but I want to go ahead and I kind of want to get this project finished. And I don't want to feel like it's being rushed. I kind of do want to do other projects. So, like maybe the slime farm and some other stuff on the server, like I did on with the blaze farm. So I kind of want to do some other stuff like that and not just spend hours of my Minecraft time on a on my own base. So that's my motivation behind it. It's why I kind of want to get this area done. And it would be easier if I wasn't so picky and being a pain about placing all these blocks underneath here, even though, because they add absolutely nothing. But to me, they do. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to probably just sit here and place quite a lot of blocks. As you see, I have a lot of stone to use, so I might as well use it with making stone bricks. And coming in here and just lining the whole area. And before I start putting the grass, I want to make sure I have a very well thought out plan for doing the you know, the slope and stuff. So I may kind of get the contour out with made out of this these stone blocks, and then kind of add in what direction I want to go with them. So I'll be right back. Well, I am back. Of course. Is that opening? Oh yeah, that opening does go through there. It started raining, but we're fine. Don't need to worry about it. So this is what I did so far. This is how the inside of this is going to be. Like I said, there's not going to be really anything built here. It's just more decorating. I could probably do something cool with this space. But for now, I'm not going to. So the problem I'm running into now is I do have these platforms here for a reason. I have these platforms here because I use them to get across. You know, I use them to decorate the sides, and that's why I mined out, you know, just didn't mine out everything. So I do kind of need to take a break and get all of this stuff done, but at that I'm not going to kind of bore y'all with it. Try to get it done. I still got to figure out. I don't know. More and more I'm thinking about it, I may just do a slope down as well on this side. And it's still, I think, going to look pretty massive. I think by the time it's all said and done, you're going to, you know, be down at the bottom looking up. So this area over here, I think I'm going to build into a little house, little walkthrough, fix it up. Nice wooden roof, floors, a good outside landscape area, and but fix that up and just continue to slope this down. What I'm gonna do, that kind of comes through there. This is gonna slope down below it. This is gonna kind of continue to come down and eventually wrap around here about level with this platform, and then continue to make its way down to this platform where probably from somewhere over in this area to over here is all going to be level, probably right into here. And all of this is going to be kind of slowly, like I said, slope down. So, hey. And I don't know. I don't know. I was trying to be nice, and I'll go on a little bit of a rant here into the video if people watch this far. And yeah, so I did feel bad. I wanted to kind of do this over here with the water, make it look, you know, make the around the edges of my base look pretty good. But people complained about the me putting the water there because they always run around the mountain. And before I even did that, I mined out this nice tunnel. You know, I've decorated it on both sides from, you know, the entrance over here to over there. And everybody from Ghetto Spawn just refuses to use it. I don't know. I guess maybe since it's not much of a view, they would rather just run around the edge of the mountain. Maybe, I don't know. But it kind of sucks, you know. I was going to build the tunnel through the mountain as a kind of a tribute to, you know, the Ghetto Spawn guys, since they figured they would do their own thing anyway and not be a part of this spawn. And yeah, so so you know, part of me is like, part of me wants to just forget the whole tunnel thing and just say, you know what, screw you. But I know that's mean. That's really mean. I shouldn't say that about other SMP members. But it is true. You know, they built a path over there to, and basically kind of blatantly told me, they're like, no, we're not going to use it. so I was like, okay, well, It's not Hari. I know Hari's out there. I don't know if he uses it or not. I know some people just say they forget to use it. But yeah. So the tunnel idea, and I kind of talked about it, and I may still do it. I may do it because I want it to look good and I want my mountain to look good, but it may be pointless in the way too. So a lot of extra mining out, which, you know, I've done a lot already, so I guess I can't complain there. To do it, make it work. But yeah, anyway, that's my rant. Like a couple minutes of pissed offness, I guess you could say. But yeah, so I'm gonna slip this down. It's gonna go down a few more levels a little bit later than that. And as you can see, you got pretty good opening there. But I can't take out this top layer. I stopped there because this started to get too high over here. And I was like, I need to be able to still decorate that side. So I'm going to do that off camera, spend some time doing a little bit of cleanup work, decorating it, and probably on both sides. I got to figure out where I want the grass to go. So this side does come down to there. I may do a little bit more over here, kind of clean that side up all the way down to this level, at least, since it's all coming out. This is, you know, that tunnel that cuts through right there. So this is definitely going to come in all the way down to here, because this is probably where the roof of the building I'm putting there is going to go. And then this is grass, and then this may be kind of sloping back up. Now that does kind of lead into what I'm going to do with areas like, you know, cutting in through here. I may just kind of bring this into a little farm area. I do like the idea of having to still use these outside paths to get around. Not necessarily to go all over the mountain, but at least get around enough to, you know, where you could kind of cut through the grassy area here, but you could also, or the tunnel, but you could also go on the paths. You know, you could have a fun little journey. And that's another path they could have used, you know? There's nothing to stop them running through here, running up this pathway, over and across, down the mountain, and over to, you know, the downward stairs there. But, yeah, anyway, so I've actually done quite a lot of work. And the video is getting a little bit longer than I usually make my videos. And so I got a lot of planning to do with what I've talked about, and a lot of off-camera work between cleaning that up. And I wanted before the next video, I would really like to get the walls cleaned up, or the walls done up to there, this layer completely gone, and get the stone brick layer molded all the way across to where I want to make my to the way that I want the landscape. And then in probably that next video, I may start building some of the little side buildings and get into the adding the grass and stuff back to this, so and forming the river next couple of videos maybe. So anyway, let me know what you think. Leave it down in the comments. Like the video if you like it. Like the video if you think what I'm doing here looks good. I try not to ask for too many likes. I know, but it does help. It does make me feel appreciated, and makes me think that I'm doing good work here. So anyway, this has been Kinema, and I will talk to you later.